Most of you familiar with Johann Sebastian Bach, one of the greatest composers in the history of the world, probably. I'm sorry that John got sick and had to go home this morning, because John talks about him quite frequently. In John's language and personality, he refers to him as Johann Bach. And I have to remind him, no, John, it's not Johann Bach, it's Johann Bach. But you would think that an organist would know better, wouldn't you? Amen. But I'll tell you something about Bach. I was reading a little bit about Bach. And what's great about Bach is that Bach had a great vision of who God was. I wish we could see Christ the way that Bach looked at Christ. You know what Bach said? He's one of the greatest composers in the history of the world. Whenever he was talking about the nature of music, this is what Bach said. All music should have no other end and aim than the glory of God and the soul's refreshment. Where this is not remembered, there is no real music, but only a devilish hubbub. Bach understood what it meant to see who God is. My prayer today is that we, as we see Jesus Christ, as he's revealed in the scriptures, that we too will see who he really is. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, Lord, we know that we have no ability to come before you. We know, Father, that you are a God who commands things out of us that we cannot do. But Father, you are also the God that takes hearts of stone and turns them into hearts of flesh. Father, you are the God that turns wicked hearts to believe and trust in you. And Father, while I hate the view of Jesus that is taken by the world, Lord, I also hate the view that is taken by much of the church today. And Lord, I pray today that we might see Jesus for who he really is. Lord, I pray that we will put all of our ideas and all of our preconceived notions aside, and we might bow at the feet of Christ Jesus, that we might see his glory and his majesty and his worth. Father, may we recognize that not only is he Savior, but he is absolutely Lord over heaven and earth. And whether the Pharisees fail to recognize it or whether we fail to recognize it, that does not change the fact of who he is. But Lord, I pray today that we might understand this, that our hearts might be open not only to the grace that was given us, but to an understanding of our own sin, that we might see why it is that we so badly need your grace. Father, I pray today that we might see Jesus like we've never seen him before. And Father, I pray that revival might be brought in the hearts of the people in this church. Father, we praise you today in the glorious name of Christ Jesus. Amen. I invite you to come down this morning as the music plays. If you were here this morning, the Lord is speaking to you. Maybe you need prayer. Maybe you've come to a point where you realize that you have been putting new wine into an old wineskin for much of your life. Maybe your idea of Jesus has been based on what everybody else has told you. And it's not been based on what the scripture says. Today needs to be the day that you look at the scripture, that you don't consult the Baptist faith and message, that you don't look at Baptist tradition or any other kind of church tradition. Today needs to be the day that you search the scriptures for what the Bible says about who he is. If you want to know more about who he is, come down and let me pray with you this morning. I'll be glad to talk with you. Brother Steve will be glad to talk with you. But if the Lord is speaking to you this morning, don't leave the sanctuary until you've listened to what he has to say. Maybe you need to get on your knees right there and add to you and pray. Maybe you want to come down to this altar and pray. But listen to the voice of Christ this morning as he reveals to you who he is. So what is the Lord telling you today? The Lord is speaking to you. And I'll be standing here while the music plays. You come.
Thank you. previous week where we thank you for all the blessings and the Thanksgiving that we had. And Lord, we just thank you so much, and we look forward to the seasons coming up, Lord, when we celebrate your birth. We thank you so much, Lord, for Jesus Christ. Father, as we come with this offering, we ask you to bless it for the ongoing of thy kingdom, Lord, and Lord, we just ask you to bless everyone here today, everyone that's represented, every home that's represented here today. Forgive us of our sins. I ask all these things in the name of Jesus. Amen.